In my former class, I was attending the principles of Mendel, particularly one of his principles, namely the law of segregation. I said here, this law was formulated by Mendel based on the results of the crossbreeding experiments called monohybrid cross. Based on the results of the monohybrid cross, he framed this law of segregation. Now, in this monohybrid cross, the F1 individuals possess a pair of factor for a character, they are being brought together, inherited from their parent, and during gamete formation, these two factors, they separate or segregate and pass into different gametes in their pure form. And because of this, the F2 progeny here showed the character segregation in the ratio 3 tall, that is 3 dominant is to 1 dwarf or recessive. And this is what the law of segregation Mendel has formulated. Now, such monohybrid crosses he repeated with the other 6 characters. So, in all the 7 characters that he has studied, each time by conducting monohybrid crosses, he approximately got the same result in the F2 progeny. That is in the ratio 3 tall is to 3 dominant is to 1 recessive. And here, Gregor Johann Mendel, compared to his contemporaries, he was very systematic in his work. And hence often, Mendel has been said as a genius. Now, this law of segregation based on the results of monohybrid cross, this law, the law of segregation, now, in each time, in the F2 progeny, I said the character segregated in the ratio 3 to 1. And as Gregor Johann Mendel was very systematic in his work, he meticulously conducted his work. He physically counted the individual produced in the F2 progeny. And that has ultimately made him to conclude the ratio 3:1. For example, in the above illustration, among the F2 individuals, he counted totally 1064 plants. So he counted 1,064 plants. Now out of these F2 plants, 787 they were tall, and 277 they were dwarf. This is approximately 3:1, and this ratio 3:1 among the F2 individuals, this is obtained only when there is a segregation of two factors, segregation of a pair of alleles which are being brought together in the F1 individuals, and these two alleles present in the F1 individual, when they segregate and enter into different gamete, then only this ratio is obtained. And this law of segregation is also called the law of purity of gametes. This law of segregation is also called the law of purity of gametes. The law of purity of gametes, this is the other name for law of segregation, because the gamete produced by F1 individual, they carry the factors for the character in their pure form. And hence, this law of segregation is also been described as the law of purity of gametes. Now Mendel, to confirm further this law of segregation or the law of purity of gamete, he conducted another set of experiments called test crossers. So he conducted test crosses, and one such test cross conducted by him, it has further confirmed the law of segregation or the law of purity of gametes. Now whenever an F1 individual, when it is back crossed with any of the parental type, now this is parent 1 and this is parent 2, when this F1 individual is crossed with any of the parental type, such crosses are called back crosses. Now this is one back cross. Now in this back cross, F1 individual is crossed with one of the parents. Say this is a recessive parent, and similarly when this F1 individual is crossed with another parent, so having a dominant trait, so both such crosses are called back crosses. So these two are back crosses. Then how do you define back cross? A cross between F1 or hybrid individual with one of the parental type. So such a cross is called a back cross. Now, among these two back crosses, this particular back cross This is also called the test cross. But this is not a test cross. So this back cross is also called a test cross. Then how do you define a test cross? A cross between F1 individual and the pure recessive parental variety. This is called a test cross. So this cross is both test cross, back cross as well as test cross, but this particular cross is only a back cross, but this is not a test cross. Hence, all back crosses are not test crosses, but all test crosses are back crosses. Now, what is the importance of this back cross, test cross? Now, test cross, it is important in determining the dominant genotype of the dominant phenotype. Now here is a plant or an individual having a dominant phenotype, and this individual with dominant phenotype, is it homozygous or is it heterozygous? So this can be established, this can be determined by conducting only this particular cross, namely test cross. Now here, Gregor John Mendel, he conducted monohybrid test cross. Gregor John Mendel has conducted monohybrid test cross to confirm further the law of segregation. Now this monohybrid test cross, for example, it is a cross between F1 or hybrid tall plant and pure recessive dwarf plant. So this is one monohybrid test cross. Now these are the phenotype of these two plants. Now the genotype here is capital T small t. This is the genotype of the F1 plant because it is hybrid. So always hybrid individuals are heterozygous. And the pure recessive dwarf plant, this will be homozygous for recessive allele. So these two are being crossed. Now what will be the progeny, what will be the type of the individual that are being produced in the next generation, that is F2 generation? Now here, this plant produces two different types of gametes. One half of the gametes will carry one allele, one factor, that is capital T, and the other half of the gamete here they carry the other factor, the recessive allele small t. So these are the gametes of this heterozygous tall individual. Now this produces uniform type of gametes, only one type of gamete because it is homozygous. So these are the gametes of this plant. Now when these gametes when they fuse at fertilization, the next generation that is produced here is F2 generation. Because this is F1 generation individual, so naturally the next generation will be F2 generation. So when these two fuse, the F2 plant will have the genotype capital T small t that is tall. When these two undergo fertilization, the individual of this generation will have the genotype small t, and the phenotype here is dwarf. That is, here in this monohybrid test cross, the F2 progeny, the individual produced in the next generation, will have both the types of plants, tall and dwarf, in equal proportion, that is in the ratio 1:1. So tall and dwarf plants are being produced in the F2 generation of this monohybrid test cross will have the ratio tall and dwarf 1:1. So this ratio 1 tall is to 1 dwarf, in general 1 dominant is to 1 recessive, this is called monohybrid test ratio. Monohybrid test ratio. So what is this monohybrid test ratio? 1:1. 1 dominant is to 1 recessive. So this ratio is called monohybrid test ratio. Now Gregor Johann Mendel, while conducting this test cross, he predicted the tall and dwarf plants will appear in the next generation in equal proportion, and the result that he got is along the expected lines. So what he has expected, he got the same result. And this ratio 1:1 in this test cross, this is again because of these two factors present in the hybrid individual, F1 individual. They remained unmixed and uncontaminated, and they have separated or segregated and entered into two different types of gametes. So as a result of this, the progeny comprised the plants having both the characters, tall and dwarf, in equal proportion. So this is the further confirmation for law of segregation or the law of purity of gamete. So Gregor Johann Mendel, he himself questioned the validity of his principles. Hence, he further subjected his predictions to vigorous test. Here, conducting the monohybrid test cross, he further confirmed the law of segregation. So in these monohybrid crosses, that has made Gregor Johann Mendel to formulate this law of segregation. Here we come across three different ratios that we have to remember. Now the three ratios that one has to make a note here include 1:3:1, that is a phenotypic ratio. Second, 1:2:1, genotypic ratio. So both refer to monohybrid ratio. So in addition to that, one more ratio that we have to remember, that is 1:1. So this is a monohybrid test ratio. Now this law, the law of segregation, it is a fundamental and universal principle that applies to inheritance of characters in all forms of living organisms. There is no exception to this law, that is law of segregation, and hence the law of segregation of Mendel, it is said to be fundamental and universal principle that applies to the inheritance of traits in all living organisms. Now one more law of Mendel is law of independent assortment. As before, let me attend to this law. First, by stating the law, and later its illustration. Now, first about the statement. Now, this law states that factors responsible for two or more pairs of contrasting characters in a hybrid are assorted independently of one another during gamete formation. Now let me repeat. This law states that factors responsible for two or more pairs of contrasting characters in a hybrid individual, each pair of factors segregates independently of other factors during gamete formation. Now this is a law of independent assortment. Now this law of independent assortment of Mendel, again it can be illustrated with the experiments of Mendel himself. Now Mendel, after completing monohybrid crosses, he conducted dihybrid crosses. Then what is a dihybrid cross? A cross between two individuals which differ in two characters is called a dihybrid cross. So what is a dihybrid cross? A cross involving two individuals, two organisms, which show two character difference. He is called a dihybrid cross. Now we shall give one example of this type. Now Mendel, he selected two characters, two traits in garden pea plant, and these two traits, these two characters are: one, seed shape. And in this seed shape, there are two alternative expressions. One, round shape of the seeds, and another, the wrinkled shape. The another character here is seed color. Again, this seed color, it has two contrasting characters. One, yellow color of the seeds, another, green color of the seeds. So here are totally two pairs of contrasting characters: round and wrinkled. One pair of contrasting characters are traits. Yellow and green, another pair of contrasting characters. Now Mendel, he has selected two types of blends. Both are true breeding varieties. One plant produced round and yellow seeds, and another type of plant produced wrinkled and green. So both are true breeders or pure breeders. Now here, he has selected two such plants having two character difference and crossed them, and such a cross is a dihybrid cross. Now he conducted dihybrid crosses to know how not a single character but a combination of two characters is going to be inherited. He is going to be pass it to the future generation. So here is not the inheritance of a single character, but here it is the question of a combination of two characters, how two characters, they are being passed on to the future generation. This was the aim of Gregor John Mendel, and he studied the inheritance of a combination of two traits or two characters by conducting these what are called dihybrid crosses. Now in one such dihybrid cross, he has selected two pure breeding garden pea plants. The one is a pure round and yellow garden pea plant. This plant produced round type of seeds and having yellow color, and this has been crossed with a pure breeding wrinkled green plant. So these form the parental generation. So they are the parents. Now both are pure breeders. Now we shall denote here the genotype of these two plants. Now here, round character is controlled by the gene denoted as capital R. Now because this is a pure breeder, for round shape of the seeds it is capital R, capital R. Again yellow. Now this yellow color, it is because of another independent gene, and this is capital Y. And because it is homozygous pure breeder, so this is one parental plant, round yellow phenotype, capital R, capital R, and capital Y, capital Y, the genotype. Now another parental plant here is pure wrinkled green. Now this wrinkled shape of the seeds is because of a recessive allele, small r. And because it is a pure or homozygous individual, small r, this is the genotype for wrinkled shape of the seeds. And small y, these are the genes for green color. Now these are the two parental plants which have been selected for this cross. And because here the two parental plants showed two character difference, this is a typical dihybrid cross. Now when he conducted this dihybrid cross, the generation that is produced next year is the F1 generation. Now how are the plants of this F1 generation? We shall show the plants of the F1 generation diagrammatically. Now this plant produces the gametes. Now always the gametes will have one gene for every character. So out of these two, one. Out of these two, one. So this, the gamete produced by this plant. Similarly, the gamete produced by the other parental plant. Out of these two, one. Out of these two, one. So these are the gametes of these two individuals. Now when such gametes fuse at fertilization, the next generation that is produced here is F1 generation. And how are the plants produced in this F1 generation? Now capital R, small r for seed shape, and capital Y and small y for seed color. So this is the genotype of the plants of F1 generation, and all these plants of F1 generation, they produced round and yellow seeds. Plants producing wrinkled and green seeds did not appear. But all the plants produced in F1 generation, they are invariably round yellow. Now this indicates that in garden pea plant, out of these two, round and wrinkled, always round shape of the seed is dominant and wrinkled shape of the seeds is recessive. So in the according to the principle of dominance, as explained by Gregor John Mendel again, always out of a pair of factors for a character, only one is expressed and other is hidden, inhibited. So therefore here, the F1 glands, even though they have the factor for round shape as well as for wrinkle shape, but the plant will produce only round shaped seeds. No wrinkled variety of seeds have been produced. This is because the factor or the gene for round shape is dominant over the wrinkled. Similarly, yellow color is dominant over the green. So here, the plants of F1 generation, even though they have the factor both for yellow color and green color, but the green color did not appear and only yellow color appeared because the factor for yellow color is dominant over the factor for green color. So this is how all the F1 plants that are being produced here, they are round yellow. But even though these plants in their phenotype, they resemble the round yellow parents, but genotypically they are different. So this parental plant, round yellow, it is homozygous. Whereas the plants of the F1 generation, which are also round and yellow, but they are heterozygous. They have a pair of alleles for every character, not a pair of identical genes or similar genes. Now when these F1 plants are, selfed, when they are crossed among themselves, what type of progeny will appear in the next generation? In other words, what is the nature of the F2 progeny? Now here, Mendel predicted, Mendel assumed that the two pairs of factors for these two characters in the hybrid individuals or in F1 individuals, these two pairs of factors, each pair of factors assert independently of the other pairs during gamete formation. So that is what this law of independent assortment says. So here, Mendel predicted that this pair of factors for this character and this pair of factors for this character, see here, during gamete formation, each pair of factors segregates, asserts independently of other pairs of factors. That is, capital R during gamete formation, it can go either with capital Y or it can go with small y. It has equal chance to go either with capital Y or with small y. Similarly, the allele for a wrinkled shape, that is small r, it can either go with capital Y or it can go with small y. So this is what the law of independent assortment proposed by Mendel. So if the prediction of Mendel, that is law of independent assortment, is true, then each of the F1 plant produces how many types of gametes? Four different types of gametes are being produced in equal proportion. So one plant will produce four different types of gametes in equal proportion. Similarly, another plant which has been crossed here will also produce four different types of gametes in equal proportion. So four different types of gametes from one plant and four different types of gametes from the other plant. When these four different types of gametes of the two parental plants here, when they undergo random fusion, produce F2 generation, and here we get 16 combinations. And these 16 combinations in the F2 progeny, it can be diagrammatically presented with the help of Punnett square. Now let me, so there is no space here to continue, you can continue, but I shall just continue the rest of the part here. Here are 16 boxes. To indicate 16 combinations of F2 generation. Now this is the F2 generation. So, 16 combinations are produced in this F2 progeny. This is because 4 different gametes of one plant, same male gametes of one plant, and these male gametes are capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. I said earlier, during gamete formation, each pair of the factors asserted independent of the other pairs during gamete formation. So this capital R can go with either with capital Y or small y. So capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y. Similarly, the small r, it can go either with capital Y or with small y. So small r, capital Y, small r, small y. So similarly, we have here another type of gamete, that is female gametes. So capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Now these are the 4 different types of gametes in equal proportion produced by one plant. And these are the 4 different types of gametes also produced in equal proportion by another plant. Now when these gametes from the 2 F1 individuals, when they fuse at random, I said 16 combinations are being produced here. Now this is capital R, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So this is round hello. Similarly, capital R, capital R, small y, capital Y. This is again round hello. Small r, capital R, capital Y, small y. This is again round hello. Small r, capital R, small r, capital R, small y, capital Y. This is again round hello. Now here, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. This is again round hello. Now here, capital R, capital R, small y, small y. This is round but green. Here, small r, capital R, capital Y, small y. This is round hello. Small r, capital R, small y, small y. This is round green. Now, capital R, small r, capital Y, this is again round hello. Capital R, small y, capital Y, this is again round hello. Now, this is small r, capital Y. So here small r means this is wrinkled. So wrinkled hello. Now this is small r, small Y. This is wrinkled hello. Now capital R, small y. This is again round hello. Now capital R, small y. So this is round green. Now here small r, capital Y. So this is wrinkled hello. Now this is small r, small y. So this is wrinkled green. So these are the 16 combinations that are going to be produced when the gametes of two F1 plants, when they fuse at random. Now here we get 16 combinations. And in this 16 combination, if you just count, 9 out of 16 will be round hello. 3 out of 16 will be round green. 3 out of 16, this will be wrinkled yellow, and 1 out of 16, this will be wrinkled green. So these are the 16 combinations, and these 16 combination of genotypes show 4 combination of phenotypes. So these are the 4 combinations of the phenotypes. So this is round yellow, 9 out of 16, round green, 3 out of 16, wrinkled yellow, 3 out of 16, wrinkled green, 1 out of 16. So here, round yellow and wrinkled green, these are the combinations present in the parents, hence called parental combinations, or old combinations, or original combinations. So round yellow and wrinkled green, round yellow, wrinkled green, these are the parental combinations, or original combinations, or old combinations. But apart from these parental combinations, new combinations have appeared. So round green, you don't have either in the F1 or in the parent generation. That has been newly formed. So round green and wrinkled yellow. So round green and wrinkled yellow, you don't have in any of the earlier generations. So these two are the combination of characters which have been newly produced. And these combinations are called new combinations or recombinations. So round green and wrinkled yellow, they are called recombinations. So these two are parental combinations and these two are recombinations or new combinations. Now here, in the F2 progeny, the plants they appeared, they not only carried the combination of characters that appear in the parents, but apart from the parental combination, new type of combination of characters are also being found in some of the plants of the F2 generation. Now here, appearance of the recombinations in addition to the parental combination, this is possible only because of independent assortment of two pairs of alleles that are present here in the F1 individuals. So in this F1 plants, we have two pairs of factors. And these two pairs of factors during gamete formation, they did not restrict and having the old combinations, but here, because of the independent assortment of these two pairs of alleles, apart from a parental combination, the new combinations have also been appeared. Now, in his actual experiment, Grigor Johann Mendel, I told you earlier, he was very disciplined and meticulous in his work. He physically counted the plants that are being produced in the F4 generation as before. And out of the total 556 plants, this is the total number of plants that have been produced in the F2 generation. So out of these 556, 315 plants were round yellow, 108 plants were round green, and 101 plants, they were wrinkled yellow, and 32, they were wrinkled green. So this is almost nearer to this ratio, 9:3:3:1. So if you just divide this 556 total number with this ratio, then it should be 313. Here it is 104. Now here it is 104. Here it is 35. So these actual counted plants by Grigor Johann Mendel in his experiment, they are very close here. So these two are close, these two are close, these two are close, and these two are close. So that means he got the proportion of these four combination of characters in the F2 generation in the ratio 9:3:3:1. So 9:3:3:1, this is called a dihybrid ratio. So what is dihybrid ratio? Dihybrid ratio. So what is dihybrid ratio? This is the ratio of individuals that appeared in the F2 progeny in a dihybrid cross. So this dihybrid ratio is 9:3:3:1. So this is called a dihybrid ratio, and this dihybrid ratio, it is obtained because of independent assortment of these two pairs of alleles during gamete formation.